Hi everybody, I will present XDance, which is joint work with my PhD supervisor Rico Sennrich. And first let me briefly introduce the topic of stance detection, and then in the second step I will present our new contribution. So this tweet is a good example of how stance can be implicit in our speech. Because of course Taylor Swift is not just making a neutral statement, but she's expressing a negative stance towards the person she mentions, Donald Trump. Now, the goal of stance detection systems is to automatically detect such a stance given an input text. And of course, there are very different kinds of stance detection systems. The kind of system we're looking at here is a system that works with only two variables. The first variable is the text that is to be classified, and the second variable is the target of the stance detection. The system then outputs either favor or against. So in this example, against is the correct answer, because this tweet implies a stance against the target of Donald Trump. In recent years, many datasets have been created to train supervised stance detection models. For example, there's a dataset with English tweets about Donald Trump as well as other targets. And there's a dataset with Italian tweets about the Italian constitution and so forth. However, such datasets tell us little about whether a system can generalize well beyond those specific settings. For example, a system trained on English tweets is not necessarily applicable to Italian tweets. And if a system trained on the target of Donald Trump does not generalize to other politicians, then the annotation effort might not be very sustainable. So there has been a need for more systematic datasets that combine different dimensions of generalization. What is novel about the dataset we propose called XDance is its size and its diversity. With 67,000 samples, it is an order of magnitude larger than the datasets that I have mentioned a moment ago. It also contains text in three languages, which happen to be national languages of Switzerland. And finally, it covers not just a single target, but no less than 150 political issues. Now let me tell you how we were able to create such a large-scale dataset. Those of you who live in Switzerland may be familiar with the website smartvote. It's a Swiss voting advice application, and it asks all candidates for an election some questions about politics. For example, such a question is, should Switzerland strive for a free trade agreement with the United States? Now, crucially, the candidate has two ways to respond. On the right-hand side, they can click on yes, rather no or no, on a categorical scale. And on the bottom, they can write up to 500 characters to further explain or justify or differentiate their opinion. In this example, a candidate has answered the question with yes and has commented in German to translate, with our second most important trading partner, we should have a free trade agreement. And here's another example of the same question in French, and a French-speaking candidate who has answered with no and has written a corresponding comment in French. Now, on SmartVote, all of this information is supposed to help voters to decide whether they want to support a candidate in the election. But based on this resource, we have extracted a stance detection dataset. And we have exploited the logical relation between the yes or no answer and the natural language comment. So let me show you the same data in a more structured way. So you can see that the questions are available in multiple languages, including English. And for every question, there are hundreds of comments in German, French, or Italian. And each comment is annotated with the yes or no answer that the candidate has selected. We have analyzed the languages in this dataset. And we found that most of the samples are in German or French, and only a small part is in Italian. So we decided to train our model only on German and French, and to mark the Italian part of the data as held out test set in order to test zero-shot cross-lingual transfer. I'm also going to show you the topics covered by the dataset. You can see that there's a diverse range of policy issues, all the way from digitization and economy to healthcare and political system. And again, we decided to separate two topics as held out test data for zero-shot transfer. Now, to revisit the problem of generalization that was raised in the beginning, we can now test both for cross-lingual transfer from German and French to Italian, and for cross-target transfer from known topics to previously unseen topics such as healthcare. So this is basically the concept behind our new benchmark XStance. And we've also done some experiments to provide a baseline and to validate that there is actually something to learn from this dataset. And for that we have used a standard state-of-the-art classification architecture, which is BERT. We downloaded the multilingual BERT model, which has been pre-trained by Google Research in many languages. And we fine-tuned the model on our German and French training data. We had to give some thought to input representation, because we want to train the model jointly on multiple targets. So we need to inform the model about the specific target we're looking for. And for this, we divide the input into two segments. First, the question from SmartVote, and secondly, the comment that is to be classified. And on top of BERT, there is a linear classifier that predicts the class. In a fully supervised setting, which involves previously seen targets and the previously seen languages, we find that BERT can clearly surpass a simple majority class baseline with an F1 score of around 76%. On the Italian test set, which is the red bar, BERT is also much better than the baseline, but the performance is lower than in German and French, because the model has not been trained on samples in the Italian language. So much for the differences between the three languages. Now, as a second interesting result, let me show you the results on the held out topics. The supervised performance on previously seen targets is in light gray, and now dark gray is the performance on unseen targets within unseen topics, for example, healthcare. So dark gray is the zero-shot cross-topic transfer performance. And you can see that the BERT model can also generalize to previously unseen topics to some degree. But again, there is a gap between the two bars. You might wonder why the majority class baseline is lower on this chart than on the previous one. And that is because now the label distribution for a target is not available to the baseline model, because those targets are not part of the training data. So the majority class used here is not computed specifically for every target, but it is the label that occurs most often globally in the training data. As a last point, I would like to discuss the importance of the two segments. Do we really need both the question and the comment for stance detection? We have performed a series of validation experiments that verify that BERT in fact uses both the question and the comments. And while we describe those experiments in detail, I would like to show you a single qualitative example from the dataset. So here we have two different questions that have been answered with the same comment. I think the respondent here has simply copied and pasted the comment across the two questions. The comment would read in English, "I want open borders for goods and responsible citizens. The state has no right to restrict us." Now, in the context of the first question, the stance is favor, but in the context of the second question, the stance is against. And I think this example can explain why the target question can be essential for disambiguation in a stance detection problem. But we also observe that the target question is more important in the intra-topic case and less important in the cross-topic setting. Okay, so those are the main experimental findings. Let me briefly conclude this presentation and summarize what we have learned from all this. First, we have presented a large-scale dataset that we hope will help improve supervised learning in stance detection. And second, because the dataset is diverse in languages and topics, we have been able to test transfer performance of a standard classifier. We found that a multilingual BERT model trained on XDANCE has a certain capability to perform zero-shot cross-lingual and cross-target transfer. On the other hand, there is a gap in performance between the supervised settings and the zero-shot settings that could be interesting for future work, for example, by using even better representations or a more sophisticated classification architecture. If you want to use XDANCE for your own work, check out our GitHub, and we're very grateful to the SmartVote team that we can share the dataset under an open source non-commercial license. And you can also use the new Hugging Face NLP library to directly get to work with XDANCE, because it's been included in that library too. That's it for me. Thank you very much for your attention, and I'm looking forward to your questions.